1, 2, 3. Bienvenue au Décapole. Aujourd'hui,
today we have the pleasure of being joined by Mark Nelson for a very special Decouple short on the very interesting news that Gentilly-2, the lone CANDU reactor remaining in Quebec, which was to be refurbished, may be refurbished. Hydro-Quebec is examining it for this breaking news. We've got none other than Mark Nelson to provide some commentary, context. I'm excited to deep dive this more. I pay a lot of attention to nuclear in Ontario, but I am guilty of not knowing very much about nuclear history in Quebec. And, you know, I'm a Canadian, you're an American, but you seem to have your nose in everybody's business, Mark. So what's up with it?
All right. So first of all, there's been a general trend around the world of old construction projects and nuclear getting revived. And I think we're going to see more of these around the world, more on that in future episodes. And we're also seeing plants that have recently been shut down, even very close to Canada, like Palisades in Michigan. Suddenly all the politicians were like, wait, nuclear is popular now. We didn't expect it to close. What about our tax revenue? And suddenly they're going to try to save it. I got to tell you, Quebec was not on my radar for this shutdown. So Quebec has had one nuclear plant active. It's got a big CANDU and a little CANDU, both decommissioned. The big CANDU, that's about 670 megawatts of capacity, enough for a bit under a million people. Well, that got shut down in 2013. And to cut it short, the issue was Quebec thought it didn't need the electricity. They have tons of dams. They have something like 98% of their electricity coming from hydro. They feel that they had hydropower for the Quebec grid, and that was enough. When you tell people about the grids in North America, it's kind of funny. You say, well, you've got the eastern interconnection going from Florida to Ontario. You've got the western interconnection going from Colorado to California to Seattle to Vancouver. And then you've got Texas, and you've got Quebec. Those are the four main grids in America. East, West, Texas, and Quebec. And in both Texas and Quebec cases, you've got almost like mini nations that feel themselves culturally separated. Legally separated is the goal of some people there. Well, in Quebec, they have tons of hydro, and they think they didn't need this silly, Anglo-Canadian power from the nuclear plants. So they shut it off. Then something interesting happened. They stopped expanding hydropower in Quebec, and they started doing business deals to sell hydropower all around the borders of Quebec. And then in Ontario independently decided to maybe shut down some of its nuclear reactors and other ways of getting energy like the Green Energy Act did not come in as expected and had to be shut off. So suddenly you went from we have too much power to actually, we don't quite have enough power. And it's not even just the balance of power over the course of the year. Quebec, for many years, has run an extremely narrow margin in the wintertime between expected peak demand and the amount of electricity they had supply of. So instantaneous power issues, and maybe like 1-2 days in a row issues during the coldest periods. So the future of sustainability is almost essentially one thing, electrification with clean electricity. So also good for Quebec because they've got clean electricity. But when you add the load and you reduce production in surrounding regions, like, for example, Vermont. Vermont had one power plant of note and they shut it off right after Gentilly and Quebec was shut off in 2015. It was almost exactly the same size and Vermont went from being way more than self-sufficient electricity with no seasonality to dependent on imports all the time, including potentially from Quebec and from Canada. So everybody can't import from everybody else at the same time. It doesn't work like that. New York turned off a huge bit of their power. Massachusetts turned off their only nuclear plant and have to rely on others. You've got all these things, all these states that had energy plans of rely on Quebec. Suddenly, Quebec's got these power deals where they're offering power to customers. They often retain the capability of choosing when that power goes, but you can only do that so much without expanding hydro before you run into deep trouble. Then you had the anti-nuclear politics, which have clearly been getting weaker and weaker and weaker. And at the point that Justin Trudeau sits in a meeting with Olaf Scholz, and that Justin sits there and says how excited that he was to get German factories powered by his nuclear fleet, the writing is on the wall for the centrist anti-nukes. To remain in the center, they gotta become pro-nukes. Now we get to something interesting about CANDUs. The insides of CANDUs are so darn modular. You've got all these little forgings that can be replaced with local supply chains in Canada that are highly experienced and delivering outstanding products that are rapidly being installed because it's the same equipment as in the other CANDU plants that are being renovated all around. CANDU has the advantage that it can be renovated. It has the disadvantage that it has to be almost completely renovated. These two things are kind of in tension, but it means there's an active supply chain doing midlife or early life renovations across Canada that can merely be put into place with a known schedule and a known budget to restore the operation of that plant as long as they haven't destroyed the containment and have to rebuild that. Almost everything else they can fix using the existing supply chain on offer. So, very exciting, Chris. Quebec is not going to be a parasite if they can get this on. Now, it would still represent just a small portion of their annual generation. So they generate about 200 terawatt hours, give or take a bit. But Chris, even hydro is weather-dependent energy. And if you want to have extra hydro available to sell at a premium to back up other people's energy system, you had better have your baseload needs taken care of. And that's part of what they're looking for. Bringing that nuclear plant back for its all-winter, constant-on energy. And I can't think of a more exciting, out-of-the-blue piece of news I've heard recently in nuclear.
Okay, so Mark, everybody wants a piece of that clean Quebec hydro. Our anti-nuclear folks in Ontario are urging us to, shut down our nuclear fleet because we can do it all with wind, solar efficiency, and those sweet imports from Quebec, ignoring, obviously, the seasonality you were mentioning. We've talked about Quebec before in the context of having pursued more of a hard path, generating a bunkload of clean electricity with this, some would say, overbuild of hydroelectricity. And in some ways, that's reminiscent of France, where they also, I think, heat with electricity in the winter. So these big kind of changes in seasonal demand. One thing you were mentioning is, Quebec is getting tapped out. They import actually electricity from us in Ontario for those very cold days you were mentioning. The size of Belgium, or for North American listeners, the size of Florida.
No amount of destroying land is too much, as long as you can avoid nuclear power.
Well, that's just the thing. In our Case for CANDU report, we were looking at the land use of the James Bay Hydroelectricity Project, which is not all of Quebec Hydro. It's just the largest series of dams they constructed. And the land use comparison to the whole CANDU fleet, the uranium mines, and the supply chain. That's 20 square kilometers for CANDU, to make that intelligible, that's the size of the Pearson International Airport. This was really great original research that we did that I felt was pretty interesting. And it's not easy to build big hydroelectric dams anymore and flood other people's land. So that may be what's underlying this move by Quebec to look at the restart of Gentilly. Thank God that the decommissioning was just put on hold without them going all German on those reactors. And
hey, look, Germany hasn't gone all German on the reactors. You're more talking the nearby shutdowns in Indian Point, where almost the absolute crucial need for those reactors was the reason why they had to destroy them as rapidly as possible to make sure that there's no risk of them coming back under the high demand scenario.
I was there. I saw that big gash in the containment. In Indian Point, a real tragedy. Mark, we're going to do these, keep them shorts. When we say decouple short, we mean short, man. Thank you for joining us for this breaking news. Really exciting, and hope it comes to something. Thanks for providing some context.